change filter. How old are the batteries in here? All right, let's start with two new batteries.
Okay.
You have two new AA batteries?
AA, pretty sure.
Yeah, let's start with that first and then see why the heat's not working after that if it doesn't come on. All right, this is RH and W. Two wires. Thank you very much. Still flashing change filter. Does not want to go away. Okay. So let's set this to heat. Seventy. And hold. All right, you have ignition. Okay. It's working now. April Air 210. Filthy. All right, before we do anything, let's do a combustion test. See how she's burning. Right there in the center of the flue. Let's see how she does. All right, 390s, stack temperature 6.902, 26 parts per million CO, gross efficiency 82.2, and 7.8 of CO2. Not necessary on a draft-induced furnace with a power vent, we know with the draft inducer, but let's test for draft. Of course, it's negative pressure, it's going right up the chimney. Let's bring this up to around 400 that our stack temperature was at, and we'll clipboard the results. All right. Okay, pressure switch works. Why do you make this so difficult? You wrap this thing around here a million times and now I can't take it off to update it and write like a human being. Why? Oh, I spent more time wasted wrapping this thing like, I don't know, like you're, like, why do this? You just wrap it normal, you can take it off. See? I need to fight with it to update this. See? Just like that. All right, let's check manifold gas pressure on the manifold side or the outlet side of the gas valve is a test port. And we're gonna make sure that we have the proper amount of gas leaving the gas valve, which is 3.5 inches. Of water column for natural gas. Good. that when it opens up. I should have it on. Under 3.5 inches of water column. Let's let this run for another minute and see if we increase to 3.5 inches. Alright, I made a slight adjustment to the gas pressure. We're at 3.5 inches of water column. Jumping around a little bit from 3.49 to 3.52. So quite happy with that, and that adjustment was just under this brass cap. Do not adjust this unless you're qualified. Beautiful. So we're still at 3.5, between 3.45 and 3.53 is the max. So I'm quite content with these numbers now. A little bit better than it was before, because the minimum manifold pressure is 3.5 inches of water column based on the rating plate. I'm gonna turn off the gas, take out my adapter, and put the plug back in on the manifold test port. Now I turned it off, and that turns the gas off, leaving the gas valve. And then when the furnace sensed there's no more flame, it's doing a power cycle. Let's turn that back on and continue testing. Gotta stay on top of the filters. Alright. Let's see if there's anything out of the ordinary. Look at that saddle valve. Oh, it's actually not a saddle valve, it's a T there. And that is a half inch sweat by female T there. And then looks like a quarter inch by half inch bushing, and then a quarter inch valve feeding the eighth inch ice maker tubing feeding the humidifier. Alright, continuing our visual inspection. Alright, good airflow there. Front door, good airflow. Set this for 68 degrees. Alright, furnace turned off. Excellent.